Welcome to the Gummy Bear Show.
One last balloon to blow up! And we've just finished hanging streamers and wrapping the presents. I had no idea blowing balloons could be so uplifting.
I'll bet Granny Peters is going to be really surprised when she drops by tomorrow morning.
Well, that's the point of a surprise party, right? I don't know about you guys, but all this decorating has totally worn me out. I'm ready for bed. Me too.
Me three. I'm going to be out like a light the second my head hits the pillow. Not good.
Okay, minor setback in the drifting, blissfully off to sleep department.
But I'm sure that with a huge brain and a little good old-fashioned ingenuity,
this baby can block out whatever silly noise is keeping me awake. I don't hear any snoring. I don't hear any snoring. Would you please shut up with all that I don't hear any snoring stuff so I can get some sleep, which I can't do because of that irritating,
infuriating,
exasperating snoring! Psst! Peters!
Hey! Keep it down with the knocking, you clown! It's the middle of the night! Okay, if any of us wants to get a wink of sleep to be fresh for the big surprise party tomorrow, we've got to somehow stop that snoring. And fortunately, I've got a brilliant plan to do just that.
Great! Let's go for it!
Here's what we'll do. First, we get a ladder and lean it up against her open second floor window. Then Dummy will climb up. And with his dodo bird feather I've attached to the end of a stick, he'll lightly tickle her feet and awaken gently sleeping.
And snoring like a buzzsaw.
Granny Peters, easing her back to smiling consciousness, and presto, solving our problem. It couldn't be simpler. I mean, seriously, guys. With such a brilliant plan, what could possibly go wrong?
Great! Let's go for it!
Do you hear the loud noise? Are we on the attack? Is it a monster or the sound of a truck? It could be a lumberjack cutting down trees. Or it could be a swarm of mad killer bees. Is it outside or is it next door? It sounded to me like a lion's roar. Is it thunder I hear rumbling from afar? Or is it the exhaust of a motor car? It's raining, it's pouring. Granny Peters is a snoring. She snored so loud it gave us a fright. She's been snoring hard all night. It's raining, it's pouring. Granny Peters is a snoring. She snored so loud it gave us a fright. She's been snoring hard.
Between you and me, I kind of like the plan better the way you first told it.
Now that you mention it. So did I. Oh.
Wait! Can't you hear it?
Hear what? I don't hear anything.
Exactly. Isn't it incredible?
I hate to say it, but you're not making a whole lot of sense, Carla.
Think, guys. You don't hear anything!
OMG! There's no more snoring!
Okay, the ladder's broken, but if only there was some way to get back up to that window to wake Granny Peters, what we need is a brilliant idea!
Well, Lucky for us, I just happen to have one!
Let me go on record as saying that this breaks every known law of physics.
Then I guess there are still a few unknown ones out there, right? Nothing like an alarm clock to wake up even the deepest sleeper. Luck to wind up with the only bird in the world scared of heights.
Get me down!
After you do your cuckoo routine and wake up Granny Peters.
Cuckoo! There, satisfied?
This isn't good. And so it's getting worse.
Now that definitely defies yet another known law of physics.
Yeah, great, isn't it?
Woohoo! Gummy, are you okay?
Yes, Gummy, are you?
Well, apart from feeling a little, well, deflated, I'm great. And it's double great to see you finally awake, Granny Peters. Come on, since it's practically morning now, there's something Harry Collar and I want to show you.
I've had a bit of a cold. I hope I wasn't snoring.
What? Snoring? You?
No, no, not at all.
Okay, you can open your eyes now, Granny Peters.
Surprise!
Oh, thanks so much, kids.
I really can't tell you how much this all means to me. I hope they don't snore.